This is a power position. And the person here is doing this because they have a sense of power and control over you. And the two hands constricting, of course, is detrimental to your ability to breathe. You will see other martial arts try to train where she slams down on my elbows midstream. This will not work under threat to life scenarios with someone intent to kill you. It really won't. In fact, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have her slam as hard as she can. And she's trained, she's strong, stronger than she looks. And I'm gonna sit there and just keep driving into her with this, and we'll see how that works. Go, come on. Yeah, it doesn't work. And this is with a stronger guy on this end, because I've done this. This is how I know throughout my history of developing core JKD, I train this stuff hard. I make sure that it actually works in street encounters, and that won't work. It just really won't, because a lot of people tend to train without intent. If my intent is to kill her, that means I do not relieve pressure on this. I do not stop and hold here and then allow her to do the drill of slamming the arms down and then, oh, I am so, or what are some of the other silly ones? Well, you know, you can search for it and you'll find the silly ones. The ones that actually work are the ones that move the body. She is going against a force that we're going to assume right here is stronger than she is. So rather than trying to move me, my mass, my strength, she moves herself because that's what she has control over. That's why learning to train against resisting opponents to keep your balance and your base against in a variety of environments is extremely important. So in this particular case, what does work is right off the bat, it doesn't matter which hand is in here that she goes for. Now she chose one that will send me into the tree, but gives her more escape on the outside. So peripherally, she's already, you know, seen some of the surroundings. There, it's really hard for her to escape. Out here, it isn't. So for her to make it so that I spin in this direction is favorable to her survival. She doesn't try to do any battering down against my strength. She simply works to secure the meaty part of the thumb. And in that particular case, that's the first thing. And this is while she's doing the other thing, which is vitally important, is taking out my eyes. She stabs the eyes with a really good shot. At the same time, now this is all occurring at the same time, she's shifting her hips out. This is vitally important. You have to learn to shift the hips out, then you can move the rest of the body out of the way. What people tend to do is they tend to overwork the arms, strength versus strength, and things like that. They don't realize your base, your footwork to enable your base escape is vitally important to what you're doing on the high line. She's already secured the meaty part of the thumb. She's got her elbow as close to the body as she can. She's going to pull it down to her side. So all she's going to be doing is ripping this open. She's not going to sit there and pull out and then try to go this way, because that lessens the amount of strength she has to deal with this lever system. So she pulls it down to her side. And you'll see how her body reacts as she's doing that. She's rotating. The thing that facilitates that is her step and her movement. She shifts and her hips come out. You always have to think about getting your butt out. It's really the way that will save you on the ground and up against obstacles. Regardless of what I'm doing, if I'm going like this, all she has to do is shift her hips out, and that starts the process of escape. So she's already taking the meaty part of the thumb, and you'll notice how my hand articulates. My hand natural movement is like this. When she rotates, my hand naturally turns in that direction, so she's already gained through the natural movement of my limb. She's just added to it a little bit of a control here that then starts putting a lock on the wrist. Now, if she's maintained a good thumb grip on there, she will secure a supine lock. And during this, she moves out after she's hit my eye. And since her hand was out in the area offending my eyes anyway, she grabs and pulls and slams my head into the tree. And then she finishes it off with another strike to the head or an elbow to the head. That would save her the bones, small bones of her hand. So again, this is the slow process, and this is the method that would go. from here. It's a slam up against there. And if you don't train this realistically, you're not going to be prepared for the intensity of somebody that's doing this with a mock intent even, because some of us are pretty good actors and we can sit there and really look like we're going to kill somebody. And if you're training with that intent and that mindset, that gives her a better response on how to deal with it, how to calm herself down and let the body's training take over. She's not paralyzed by fear because she's been here, she's done this. She's secured this immediately. As soon as somebody touches her, she makes sure to secure whatever is touching. She goes to one side because peripherally she's seen what's the best escape. She shifts as she strikes. If you notice how her movement as she rotates, it actually puts her striking hand in a closer position to me. So her movement to the side like that extends, gives her better range on the actual strike. So through there, rotate, strike, grab the head. Now her hips are out, she's got good base. She's got good stability. Now she finishes it off with an elbow. She can crack me with an elbow as she rotates her butt out and then finishes the lock. So she's secured the lock on here as well. So she can double up on that, turn me out to the side, and put a tremendous amount of pain on me. Now that's pain compliance, but she could also, if it's a life-threatening scenario, slam my head a few more times with the elbow so she can escape, or an elbow and then a knee combination if I drop down to that level. Don't bring your knee up to a higher level. Wait until the head is down to that level. And that means you can control the head position, especially if she's already popped my eyes, slammed my head against a tree, and put me down. So train at a place that gives you techniques, but also sensible techniques. Some of the techniques are just ridiculous. You look at some of the stuff that's out there and you say, these people haven't done this against a resistant opponent who has got an intent that continues to drive toward their intent, and who is stronger than them, and who has a different, or weaker, and then who has a different height and different arm length and everything else. You've got to put that in play. Otherwise, you're not training for reality. And that's okay if you don't want to do that. There are people who train in martial arts for a lot of different reasons. And some of those reasons are just a social setting. Some of them are just to get good exercise and things like that. But we're in the business of doing things to help protect your life in a life-threatening situation. That's Corey JKD.